All right, so we got some fucking ESP here. The original formula. If you don't know what ESP is, it's some crazy pre-workout that Jesse somehow got his hands on. And how many scoops should I take right now? I'm about to go. How do you deadlift?
So one scoop is 500 milligrams of caffeine and a bunch of other crap. I don't know. I mean, I know you have a huge tolerance. So.
Okay, so I don't know. Just take this real quick.
One big scoop.
We're going to take one fat scoop to the dome.
I take one small scoop every time I take
okay,
it.
Okay, so you show that real quick. There's a small one and there's a big one. I'm going to go big because go big or go home, right?
Sometimes it's fun.
All right, let's get it. Motherfucker. Get out of my fucking chair. The fuck did I tell you about sitting in my fucking chair? I swear to fucking God.
Such a good boy. Yes. 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 Yes.
Alright guys, Sebastian Berger here coming out with you new coming out. You can do this. Alright guys. It's Sebastian Berger here coming out with you. Sebastian Berger here coming out with you. What the fuck? Oh my god. Let's do it one more time, ready? Alright guys, Sebastian Berger here coming at you with a new video this week, and today we're going to dive into a topic talking about something that I've personally struggled with over the past 7 or 8 years. How to get bigger faster for skinny guys or hard gainers, which I am myself. So when I started lifting, I was about like 105 pounds, I was skinny, I looked like Anne Frank, I was like just bone. One thing I want to mention before we like get any deeper into this topic. There are no shortcuts here. So it doesn't matter how many fucking supplements you take. You could take all the steroids in the world. There is no substitute for nutrition. There just isn't. And I know the title says faster, but we're just gonna forget that word faster because it's honestly just a way to get you guys on this video. It's clickbait. There is no fucking shortcuts here. It's day in, day out process. This shit takes years. It doesn't happen overnight. So get that out of your head, but I am gonna tell you guys what you need to do to make consistent progress. And if you are a skinny guy or a hard gainer, these are the things that you have to do to put on that size. And it may not happen overnight, like I said, but it will work if you are consistent with it. And that is the key. I'll tell you what I did. So I started lifting when I was like consistent, like eighth grade. Yeah, I started in eighth grade. And by the time I got to ninth grade, I realized I needed to eat a lot of fucking food. And I was natural this time, so, you know, my diet pretty much consisted of just about everything. And I had a staple of 9 meals that I would eat every single day. I would eat 9 meals in high school. I would wake up every morning, 5:30 a.m., and I would force feed myself 2 cups of oatmeal, like 4 whole eggs, 2 cups of milk, 2 cups of orange juice. And I would say like about 3 out of 5, maybe 2, 3, 5 out of those 5 school days, I would throw up before school from trying to force feed myself this shit before I would get on the bus. And you know, it sounds crazy, but I just want you guys to understand that that's the type of mentality you have to have when you wanna grow and you're a skinny fucking guy, because your body does not wanna put on that weight and you have to force yourself to put on that weight. And it's not easy. By no means is it easy. It's fucking horrible. It's unbearable. You don't want to do it. You don't want to eat. And I was so religious with it. I was like a stickler, you know. Every 2 hours on the dot, I would bring my meals to school. I would get kicked out of class for eating my meals in school. I dropped out of high school so I could eat my fucking meals. That's how dedicated I was to this lifestyle. Those are the things that I had to do to put on weight with my body type as an ectomorph, as I guess I would describe myself, and most of you would describe yourself as well. Just skinny guy, hard to put on weight, and you're not seeing much progress in the gym no matter what you do. And it really, really just comes down to how much you're eating, and more importantly, what you're fucking eating. The way I did it when I was younger is, like I said, I would eat 9 meals, I would eat that oatmeal and stuff, and I would eat peanut butter sandwiches, I would have a box of mac and cheese for one of my meals. It was disgusting. It was fucking disgusting. But did I gain weight? Yes. I went from 130 pounds to 165 pounds in a year. That was my goal. I entered a prep, did my first show when I was 17. And yeah, but out of those 35 pounds that I gained, how much of that do you actually think was muscle, especially as a natural teenager? Not a lot. Not a lot at all. I ate like shit most of the time, and I put on weight, which is what I felt like I had to do, right? Because that's what all skinny guys feel like you have to do. Why can't I put on weight? Why is the scale not going up? And I want you guys to understand that that is not always important. You don't need to focus on that. You don't need to focus on the scale, because muscle grows in grams. It doesn't grow in pounds. I'm gonna break this down for you guys real simple. Quality over quantity. So right now I sit at about 176 pounds on average. You know, I wake up at 176. I have been this weight for the past 4 years. And if you look at pictures of me 4 years ago, I'll put up some right here, at 176 pounds versus 176 pounds now, the difference, I don't even need to, there's not much to say. It's the scale didn't go up, but my body changed immensely. And that is because of my nutritional intake. What you guys eat is way more important than how much you eat. And I don't say that to say, like, you know, oh, eat healthy foods in little quantities and it's better than eating a bunch of shit. No, you still need to eat large fucking quantities, but large quantities of nutritional whole foods is going to benefit you like fucking 500 times more than you eating shit day in, day out just to get those calories in, just to see the scale go up for an egotistical boost. Don't pay attention to the scale, because it really doesn't fucking matter. And like I said, you know, when I was younger, I did that too. Everybody's gonna do that, especially as a skinny guy, because you just wanna see your weight go up. You just wanna put on some size, and that's really all you're concerned with. You just need to understand that the scale isn't always the best judgment. Maybe the mirror is, you know. Like I said, muscle goes in grams, not pounds. It's not an overnight process. You just gotta be consistent with what you do. Consistency is everything, guys. Consistency is so fucking important, you would not believe how important consistency is. You could have a week straight of eating perfect, you know, 4,000 or 5,000 calories a day. All your meals are great. Steak, rice, potatoes, just huge portions. You know, you feel great. You feel so progressive. And then you have 3 days where you're off. Every week you have 3 days where you're off. That's gonna fuck everything up. It's gonna fuck with your thyroid. It's gonna fuck with how your insulin responds to things. You guys need to be consistent with how you eat. If you're gonna have those 6 meals every day, you need to make sure you're eating those 6 meals every single day, because you can't increase if your body doesn't adapt to a certain amount. So the whole goal with putting on size, putting on weight, is to have, you know, a standard 5-6 meals, you know, that are consumed of proteins, fats, and carbs. So for example, 6 ounces of chicken, 2 cups of rice, maybe like 10 grams avocado oil, right? You wanna eat that. Just to say, for example, those are all your 6 meals, which it never would be, but just say for example, those are all your 6 meals. You wanna be able to eat that every fucking day for the next month. And then after that month, once you've adapted to eating that, it's gonna become much easier for you to eat as you eat it more often. It's not gonna become as hard, which is a good thing, right? Because you wanna be able to have your metabolism function at the most optimal level, so you can increase your calories and eat more food of the same type of quality. You don't wanna be throwing in all this bullshit just to get those extra calories in. You wanna be able to eat those 6 meals of that 6 ounces of chicken, 2 cups of rice, and 10 grams of avocado oil. And then after a month, you wanna be able to increase that to maybe 8 ounces of chicken, maybe 2.5 cups of rice. I don't know, I'm just throwing out numbers out there. This is not realistic, I'm just throwing out numbers. You wanna be able to increase from a given point. And you can't do that unless you're consistent on a daily basis. Your body just will not respond correctly. You will not be hungry enough to eat it. And then that comes into factor when you start force feeding yourself and whatnot. And you do have to force feed yourself to some degree, but like I said, when I was younger, I was throwing up before school like half of the week, and that's just not beneficial, right? It's just not, at that point, it's not benefiting me. It's hurting me more than it's benefiting me. And you know, I had that mindset where it's like, all or nothing, I have to eat this oatmeal now or I'm gonna get fucking small and I can't get bigger. But guess what? I just threw it all fucking up. So where does it go? I didn't even get to absorb any of those nutrients, right? You guys just gotta understand that. Okay, so now that we understand the importance of consistency, and that applies to every aspect of fitness, right? So everything that I mentioned, consistency is a factor. It is extremely important if you want to progress. Let's talk about some of the other factors here. Cardio. Now, I'm sure everybody's thinking, why would I do cardio? You know, I'm a skinny guy. Cardio is for people who want to lose weight or get leaner, blah, 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 blah. Cardio is the last thing you want to do if you want to build muscle or get bigger, especially as a skinny guy. This is wrong. This is false. This is not true. I hate to break it to you, but it's not true. And unfortunately, we are all led to believe this bullshit by some fucking 40-year-old dude at the gym who shot out and thinks he knows what he's talking about, even though he never had a pro card or anything. Cardio is important no matter what your goal is. Let me give you an example here. Say you do cardio every morning fasted. You go do 20 minutes fasted cardio in the morning and you're 120 pounds. You're still fucking struggling to eat a lot and put on this weight, especially whole foods. You can't eat large quantities of whole food or whatever. You go do fast cardio in the morning. You wake up, do that fast cardio. You are going to be so much hungrier. You're going to be able to eat such a bigger meal, especially for breakfast, which is extremely important. And it's overall just going to help you more than hurt you in the long run. It really, really is. Cardio is great for metabolic purposes, not just for burning fat and all these other things and all these misconceptions you read about, along with obviously heart health and just being a healthy individual in general, which most of us probably aren't even concerned with because our goal is to get bigger and strong as fuck, which is definitely not the healthiest thing for your body. If you're a skinny guy, do some fasted cardio. You're gonna be able to eat a much bigger breakfast. Trust me, you'll be surprised how much hungrier you'll be after you do 20 minutes of fasted cardio, especially if you're not used to that shit. You're gonna be like, fuck, I'm fucking starving. Especially just upon waking up too. Trust me guys, do your cardio. What's another thing we should factor in here? How to get bigger for skinny guys. So what do skinny guys struggle with the most? Obviously the eating aspects, all right? When we talk about eating these whole foods consistently on a daily basis, 5-6 meals, I gave you that example, 6 ounces, 2 cups of rice, whatever. The key is to start lower and then you can gradually increase so you adapt to this. You don't wanna start, if you're a skinny kid and you're just starting off, oh, I'm gonna eat 6 ounces of chicken and a cup of half of rice and this and that, you're just not gonna be able to eat that shit probably, especially if you have a hard time eating, you're just not gonna be able to keep up with it. So don't have super high expectations of yourself when subconsciously you know you can't do something. You know you're not gonna be able to put down that 4,000 calories a day easily without fucking struggling or missing a meal here and there. The goal is you wanna be able to look at your meal plan or your diet and say, I could do this every single day. It might not be the easiest, but I am able to do this. A lot of people jump right into something and they don't even understand how hard it is to actually keep up with that. And you have to work up to something like that. So like, if I was, say, I was like 120 pounds, 130 pounds, what I would start at like 4.5 ounces of chicken, 1 cup of rice, and you know, some source of fat, you know, a couple almonds or something like that. And you know, for breakfast, maybe like 3 whole eggs, 1 packet of oatmeal, a banana or something like that. You wanna start small so that you could gradually increase and then get to that point where, you know, it starts getting really hard, and then you could stay there, wait till you adapt to eating that much, and then increase from there and there and there on. You don't want to force feed yourself this absurd amount of food every single day because it is not sustainable for most people. Most people don't have the mindset to be Phil Heath. They're not going to sit there and force themselves to eat this. So you need to make decisions that are going to be sustainable for you. Okay, I know a lot of people want to have this big alpha mentality, you know, I can eat whatever, I can do whatever. Can you really do that? You need to be real with yourself. That is that. At the end of the day, you need to be real with yourself. A lot of people in fitness don't want to be real with themselves. It's very ego driven. You know, they'll throw 135 on the bench even though they can only bench 95. They'll try to eat all this food even though they can't eat it. And it's just not, that is the last way that you're going to make progress. You have to be real with yourself if you want to progress. All right, so now that we've covered consistency, starting with lower portions, gradually increasing so that you adapt to a certain calorie and macro intake, and then doing your cardio to increase hunger, able to eat larger portions of food. Now let's get into a little bit of the training aspect. How should you train if you're a skinny dude who wants to put on size? You know, me personally, when I started training, I trained like higher reps. I did more bodybuilding work, and that was just because of the environment that I was in, the way that I was kind of like taught to train. But my recommendation for anybody starting out would be to start with strength training and get your lifts up. You know, bench, squat, deadlift, focus on those. you know, really master the form, master the movement pattern, get stronger in all those lifts, progressively add weight on a weekly basis if you can. Obviously, because, you know, barbell movements like that, those compound lifts, have greater mechanical tension than like isolation work. Mechanical tension is simply just the amount of tension that is able to be put on the muscle, and you know, those compound lifts, squat, bench, deadlift, allow for much greater mechanical tension as opposed to isolation workouts, like you know, just not even isolated compound workouts. Anything with a dumbbell requires more stabilization. So when you're a skinny guy or gainer starting out, you wanna really utilize those barbell movements because they're gonna allow you to use more weight, increase weight at a much faster pace, and obviously put more tension on the muscle, which is gonna correlate to more muscle breakdown, more tension on the muscle, more ability to grow overall at the end of the day, because you're gonna be lifting heavier weights and you're gonna be able to tax your body much harder as opposed to doing stabilization workouts or anything with dumbbells. And I'm not saying neglect dumbbell work at all. I'm just saying when you're starting out, really focus on those compound lifts and progressing in those, mastering those, and just becoming overall an expert in those lifts, because those are what is gonna ultimately provide you the base for building a physique. All right, so we've got consistency, obviously. Starting with lower portions, gradually increasing. Doing your fasted cardio to increase your appetite. And we've got training for strength to create greater mechanical tension and overall get stronger, which is gonna allow you to get bigger over time and create that base for the physique. So that's four things we got down for skinny guys who are trying to gain weight. The fifth thing is gonna be take steroids and a bunch of supplements. I'm just kidding, don't do that. Seriously guys, I'm really, really serious. Steroids won't do anything for you if you're not already at an elite level and an elite mindset where you're gonna do everything you need to do to be growing in the first place. You know, without all this, without all these other things in place, and you know, without already mastering all of these other things, drugs won't do anything for you, and supplements won't do anything for you either. Supplements are to supplement on top of the things that you should already be doing to give you an extra edge. You cannot substitute supplements or drugs for food and hard work. You can't. You just cannot. Everybody wants the easy way out. Everybody wants a shortcut. Everybody wants it fast. And I know I titled this video fast, but like I said, I just did that to get you guys to watch the video. And I hope you guys really implement some of the stuff that I'm talking about right now, because if you implement these things on a daily basis, it will work over time. You will see great results. One thing I wanna add on top of the food intake is to keep your protein intake pretty high. You know, a lot of people say 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight. I don't believe that at all. I think that's complete and utter bullshit. That only works for, like, you know, maybe like some women or average person trying to be in shape and wants to retain muscle. If you're trying to gain size, you're trying to get big, I would say at least 1.5 grams of protein per pound of body weight, if not 2 grams, you know. Too much protein is not gonna hurt you. There's no such thing as too much protein. I don't care what anybody tells you. You know, I personally take my advice from pro athletes and pro bodybuilders who have an impressive physique to show. And those are the people who have always told me and have always shown to be eating 300-400 grams of protein a day. And I know that sounds like a lot, but trust me, when you're eating 6 meals of meat every time, you know, 6 to 7 to 8 ounces of meat, it's not that hard to get in 300 grams of protein, guys. It's really not. Like I said, it's really just about that consistency, waking up every day and getting right to it. You know, a lot of people really want to get bigger. You know, that's their dream. It was my dream to, like, get to a physique that I'm at now. Obviously that sounds really stupid, because obviously I'm not satisfied at all right now. I want to get way fucking bigger. But there was a point in time when I was like 13, and I'd probably see myself now and I'd be like, wow, I want to look at that. And it's like, somebody said to me the other day, it's like, dreamers wait for a moment of inspiration and the successful people get up and go to work. And that applies to bodybuilding and fitness as well. You know, you can just wait for that motivation to, like, you know, today I'm gonna meal prep and this week I'm gonna get my meals in. Or you could just get up and fucking do it every day, put your head down, go to work, and you know, the results will come. They will fucking come when you put in that work. So I hope some of this information helps some of you guys. If not, you know, fuck me, I'm a bad person, I guess. If you did like this video though, make sure you leave a like below and subscribe if you haven't yet. I will be posting new videos on here every week. You know, I'm a little inconsistent with YouTube. I'll post for like weeks on end, then I'll like disappear for like 2 or 3 months, and that's not good at all. So I'm really gonna try to stick to posting on a weekly basis and provide some type of valuable information to you guys, along with some vlogs and stuff like that, some little cool cinematic edits, because I like doing that and I'm trying to get into that as well. But yeah, hopefully this information helps some of you guys, provide some value. Hopefully some of you guys will implement this on a daily basis. Let me know what you guys think below in the comments. And yeah, that's all I got for you guys. Get big or die trying.
Gold medals on my team. These chains like trophies. Look at how they gleam. Look around at my circle. I see fiends for their dreams. It will please. So will